And if you have not gone through our previous tutorial, I am providing the link in the description section below. And I suggest you to go through the tutorial to get started with this particular tutorial, because we are continuing the previous tutorial in this particular vlog now. In this vlog, we would like to implement grouping in unit test cases. So we will be collecting all the test cases under a single group, and also we would like to add one more test case which we have discussed in our previous tutorial. In previous tutorial, as a part of assignment, I have given you increment plus 2 function here so that you can create unit test cases for them. So I think you have created the unit test cases for this particular function, and if not, we'll see this first and then we will try to implement the group under the unit test cases. And also we would like to avoid the issue which we have faced in our previous tutorial. Whenever we try to move the main to the global position, then we faced an issue like the data is not being cleared up for the next unit test case. So we will be solving that too in this particular tutorial. So now let's get started. So the first thing we do is like we need to add a unit test case for increment plus 2 here. So provide the description here like value needs to be incremented by 2. So by default every time we increment by 1, so here we are specifying increment by 2. And specify an empty function over here and start adding our test case. Okay. So the very first thing we do is like we create an object for main here. So final main, and then we will like to call the function main dot increment plus 2 here. We can find it in the drop down. So expect. So what we are expecting here to happen, like main dot value, which is initially to be 0 here, should become 2 now. So 0 plus 2 is 2, right? So let's add 2 here and now try to run this particular unit test case and see the output. Here in this particular tutorial, we don't require simulator. Here you can see we have got the output like test passed 1 here. So we try to run only one unit test case. We have got 1 of 1 test passed here. And now let's try to run all the test cases once again. Run test. And now here we can see that all the 3 test cases will be passed now. And now the error which we have faced in our previous tutorial, which is like whenever we try to declare main in global level, then we are facing the issue, right? So now let's try it again and find the solution for it. I am trying to remove all the main object declarations from the test cases and now try to run this particular code. And here, so we have got 2 test cases passed and remaining test case was failed here. So you may get a doubt like why the 3rd test case passed again and why the 2nd test case failed here. So what happened here is like value equal to 0, right? So we have incremented the value and the value became 1 here, and now we have decremented the value, and here the value should be expected like minus 1, but it became 0 here. So again value is 0. And when it comes to the 3rd test case here, as the value became 0 in the 2nd test case, whenever we try to increment by 2, then value became 2 here. So that's why here 2 test cases have passed and the 2nd test case is the one which have failed here. And if you are having any doubts, you can just expand this one and see the detail here. Value needs to be decremented has failed here. And the remaining 2 test cases have passed now. So now let's try to avoid this issue by introducing the setup here. So inside the setup, you need to declare the initializations so that this particular issue is resolved forever. So I have specified it here, and now let us try to declare variable outside so that it is visible inside the unit test cases, so that it can be accessible inside the unit test cases. Main and remove final here. So now let's try to run these 3 test cases again, and now it will be success for all the three test cases. Here we can see all the test cases are now successfully passed here. And now let's try to see the concept of grouping here, and let's try to introduce grouping for these two test cases and leave this particular test case so that we can know how the grouping works exactly. So group, and here let us specify a description for the group here. So what is the description is like main screen. Let us specify the description like main screen, and thereafter we specify a function, and inside which we specify these two test cases now. So I'm going to cut these two test cases and add inside the group here. And here you can see we have got an option to run the group test case here, like run main screen. So here main screen is the name of the group here. So whatever the name you write here, that name will be appended for the group name here. So here you can see we have got run ABC now. So this is how we declare a group. And now let's try to run the group here, run main screen, so that only two test cases will be considered here. These are the two test cases we have added into the group. Only these two test cases are being considered for unit testing, leaving the third unit test case here. So we can just run it individually, or you can just add it to this particular group if all the three belongs to the same screen. Again, when you try to run from the void main here, all the unit test cases inside this particular class will be run irrespective of the group or individual here. So this is how we classify our unit test cases under group, and also individually we can just specify them, and you can run them according to your requirement again. And this is how we can just declare in a global level the objects which we require to be accessed inside the unit test cases and make the code reuse. Okay, so this is it for this tutorial. And if you have not gone through our previous tutorial, I am providing the link in the description section below, and I suggest you to go through the tutorial to get started with this particular tutorial, because we are continuing the previous tutorial in this particular vlog now. And in coming tutorials, we would like to deal with the widget testing scenarios. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.